I'm sure this fund is going to be very appreciated by the community and add nothing but positive feedback to the community. So good stuff.
It's been good so far. So
okay. Yeah. Next up, K103 Radio is celebrating 29 years. Time flies. What do you think about that? 29 years.
Well, you guys have been there a lot longer than I have. I only kind of did the weather sucks outside today.
Probably the best story was, I remember one time she played a song, I think it was from John Mellencamp. She's like, oh, I don't like this song, I'm not going to play this, but this song I'm going to play again. And you played it, and then once the song was finished, she goes, oh, I like this song,
I'm going to play it again.
Yeah.
Didn't I say something about the fact, like, why do they call him that?
That was the best
and you,
one,
and,
yeah.
And you came back, and you were saying, well, something about... Like the first time that he came out with a song, it was like before you were born or something. I don't know, something like that, because like, you were just
true.
Like.
No, she goes.
Something not true.
The better one was she goes, yeah, that was John Mellencamp. I don't know why he changed his name though.
All right,
that's why he was better with John.
Agree that radio.
That's what she did.
DJing was never my thing. You want to hear podcast news? I will have that for you in no time.
There you go. Well, I've been there.
Leave that up to the pros.
Yeah. Well, I've been there on and off for 22 years, but Chris, you've been there since its inception.
No. I'm not that old. No, I'm just kidding. No, actually, I've been there probably 27 or 28. I started in 1982.
Okay.
That's what I remember.
So and it's 29. Was like, years.
Minus one.
Okay. It's 28. Well, you're pretty close.
Yeah.
Then.
Yeah. And yeah. I've probably the only person that is still there and has been there that's never been fired.
If you can run a list. There you go.
I might have been fired. Yeah. They might have been like, you're just done.
Yeah. No, I mean, within
there's been a lot of things. Like,
well, it's been a quick turnover. It's been that revolving door. Some people leave, some people come back. Some people leave, some people come back. Yeah. And but that's one thing. Being there all those years, I met so many really like cool people from the community, but as well as outside of the community. Yeah. And it's been, I'll tell you, it's been a ride. Mm-hmm. Interesting.
Yeah, it's
to
been
say
a
the
lot
least. Never a dull moment at K103 ever.
So congratulations going out to K103, all the people that work there and all the people that will work there.
Yeah.
And that continue to work
years
there.
And they continue to make the community radio station what it is. So congratulations, guys.
Mm-hmm.
And don't go away. We're going to head into a commercial break. And there's lots more to come, including Mohawk TV's big announcement.
Woohoo!
Yeah, when we come back.
Welcome back to the program. The Sahanaji Fund makes a generous donation. A local media personality gets honored. That and so much more coming up on Zawana Oriwaga News Briefs.
Mohawk Council of Kahnawake's Chief Mike Bush, along with Mike O'Brien, the Mohawk Council's Chief of Staff, or OCC, met with Quebec Native Affairs Minister Pierre Corbeil in Quebec City this past week. The meeting was a follow-up of Grand Chief Mike DeLille Jr.'s meeting with Quebec Premier Jean Charest last June. At that meeting, DeLille and Charest signed a statement of understanding and mutual respect. That laid the groundwork for the Mohawk Council and Quebec government to continue to discuss any and all developments, as well as the current negotiations of the 10 agreements, which focus on sales tax, tobacco, petroleum, alcohol, as well as transport and user fees. In other news, the Sahanaja Community Fund announced earlier this week their plans to fund a gala event to help with the community efforts aimed at helping cancer research. On May 15th, the Sahanaja Fund will be hosting and sponsoring this fundraising event at the Knights of Columbus. Proceeds from the dinner, dance, and auction will go directly to Team Kahnawake Cycling, who take part in the Ride to Conquer Cancer, Team Kateri Memorial Hospital Center, who take part in the Weekend to End Women's Cancer, and last but not least, Mohawk Spirit, who take part in the Avon Walk for Breast Cancer in New York City. Last year, all three groups raised approximately $200,000. The Sahanajay Fund will be covering the cost of this gala evening and will donate 100% of the proceeds to three organizations. With tickets at $100 each and 26 tables of 10, the event could potentially raise $26,000 on ticket sales alone. Also, there is an auction that's scheduled to take place at the gala event that could raise significantly more. Music will be provided at the gala, featuring local Ganawage band Sold. Tickets are now being sold throughout the community for the dinner event. Finally, two Ganawage Rono were honored by the National Aboriginal Achievement Foundation last Friday, March 26th. Ganawage's esteemed media man, Kenneth Deer, was honored with an award and medal for media and communications, along with Skowinio Barnes for Youth Achievement. Congratulations to both, and you can catch the broadcasting of the awards on May 1st on APTN. That's it for this Zawana Ordiwage News Briefs.
Don't go away. We'll be back with more on Zawana Ordiwage right after this quick break.
Welcome back to the program. Well, spring is around the corner, and here at Zawana Ordiwage, once again, we're launching a Get Fitness Challenge. It's the third edition of the Get Fitness Challenge, and we want to help you guys reach your total weight loss. You only have 1 week left to sign. The 12-week challenge begins April 12th and ends on June 28th. Regan, quickly, give us some details once again.
Okay, so it's our third fitness challenge that we're doing, and it's called The Town's Biggest Loser. And obviously, it's kind of a play on words to The Biggest Loser, which is it CBC? Or, no, it's
NBC.
NBC. So it's really to get people started on a longer weight loss goal and to lead healthier lifestyles. So we're going to make it like 12 weeks because it's something that I think people can commit to. Is a 12-week program that is like, you know, you have a cash value of maybe, you know, between $5,000 and $1,000 is our grand prize for the Biggest Loser. And then we have fitness memberships. We're going to have a walking club that starts that week to get people motivated. And then, you know, I think maybe if you meet in groups, it's like you can bounce ideas off of each other and stuff like that. So it's going to be really a lot of fun. We have you know, maybe about 20 people signed up right now.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, so it's going really well. You have 1 week. It's $25 to join. What you have to do is call here, leave your name and number, or email us at mohawktv@hotmail.com. And we're actually going to be having our first sign-up and orientation session at the end of next week. And then we're going to start fresh on the 12th.
Okay.
So if you want to be a part of it, some of the questions that people are asking, and I just wanted to kind of talk about this quickly, is that do I have to be on TV because it's Mohawk TV's, you know, like we're doing it, so
right.
People think they have to be on TV. Absolutely not. It's not a requirement for you to be on TV. If you want to, that's great, but we're not going to be, you know, taking group shots or anything like that. Like it's,
okay.
You know, there may be one or two people that we can that we can follow, but if you're not comfortable with it, then you don't have to. So that's one thing. We just want to really put it out there and have people join in and, you know, get on a good path.
Well, that's great.
Yeah.
So the email for anyone who wants to sign up?
Yes, mohawktv@hotmail.com or give us a call here at 632-6397. That's 632-NEWS.
Well, that's cool. I'm looking forward to
seeing
some of the results over the next couple of weeks.
That'll
be cool.
Yeah.
Well.
Okay.
So then finally, we do have a big announcement that we made this week.
Yes,
after nearly 8 years on the air, Mohawk TV has announced that Zawana Ordiwage will be going off the air.
Yes.
All right.
Yeah.
How about some details?
Okay, well, I mean, I don't want to say too much because actually Lance and I had a chance to do like a real sit down. We went to Dustin's, we had some coffee, and we talked at length. So we're just going to go to that interview now and give people all the details.
Let's go to Lance. Lance?
And Regan.